Yeah. Bang, bang, bang. Don't put nothing in the bang, bang, bang. So we might as well go home and have a nice cup of tea.
To the sky, entranced by the sight. These are future pilots, they will never die. These are future pilots, they one day will fly. These are future pilots, they one day will fly. Supersonic plane far into the sky. These are future pilots, they will always try to make their dream reality, to zoom and dive and fly. They all have the appearance, they one day will fly, their all coordination.
Thank you. Dick, Dick is the Weight Watcher. He's an overeater. Ratman's the Weight Watcher. Ratman must lose his Dick, Dick Watcher. Ratman the Weight Watcher. Ratman must lose his Dick, Dick Watcher.
Anne Lee, the founder of the Shaker religion, was born in Manchester, England, on February 29th, 1736. She was sent to the factory to work the machines at the age of 10. The old family was destroyed by the Industrial Revolution. Farm life had required large families. After the foreclosure and the migration of families to the city, people still continued to reproduce children who couldn't be fed. Factory owners exploited the children as cheap labor. Anne Lee was forced into marriage. Pregnancy made her feel unnatural. Her four children died young. At the same moment that mechanized work began, there appeared religions which had the function of causing the body to quake in dance and ecstasy. Anne Lee joined such a sect. They were the Quakers. She was taught to shake her body. She had visions. She believed that she was the female manifestation of Christ. God had originally made man and woman bisexually self-contained and equal. Because of Adam and Eve's sin in the garden, man was punished by having to work at labor he hated. Woman was punished by the burden of childbearing. The snake was heterosexuality. Sexual marriage was the unnatural result of man's fall. But Armageddon was coming, with the good tidings for the elect. The end was imminent. There was no need for new childbirths.
And I heard a voice from heaven, as the voice of many waters.
Pragmatically, sexual self-denial by members of a new community based on brotherhood and sexual equality could replace the evil of the patriarchal family.
And they sang a new song, they sang a new song.
Instead of being enslaved by machines, all needed goods could be produced for common needs by cooperative handicraft. Divine revelation led Anne and her group to America in 1774. She believed America to be prior to Adam's sin. The Shaker meeting hall was divided bilaterally. On one half, brothers' benches faced sisters on the other half. Separate stairs on either side led up to chambers of the chief elder who lived on the left, or to the chief eldress on the right. Power was divided equally. Workdays were devoted to sober, simple craft work. Sunday was for ritual, religious dances. The two sexes arranged themselves in four concentric circles. Rhythmically chants from the Bible while they march in circles. Stomping their feet, they shout, "Stomp the devil!" Sisters and brothers begin whirling in place. The group cries, "Shake, shake, shake, Christ is with you." There is noise like a whoosh, which means the devil is present. People clap, they leap up and down. Some remove their outer clothes. A fit of shaking, ecstatic seizures passes over the group. Reeling, turning, twisting, some shakers bow down. Others rock on their feet. Still others are doubled over, feet and hands linked as they roll on the floor. They roll over and over like a wheel, or they turn like a rolling log. Some get down on four legs like dogs, growl, snap their feet, and bark. Carnal mortification frees the shaker from false pride. Ritualistically, the devil is snared from his hiding place within the group and cast out. And the group becomes purified. Before the Shakers arrived in America, the Calvinistic Puritans had established its basic creed. The Shakers were proletarians, while the Puritans were the new emerging middle class. Work for the Puritan meant to detach himself. For the Puritan, men were divided into saints and sinners, good and evil were absolute categories. Each man was to be personally responsible for his own salvation. The Puritans believed themselves to be the agents of God's will, their purpose being to establish a new Jerusalem in America. While America prospered materially, there was always the fear that it might somehow be in the service of the devil, not God. And by the 19th century, 1800, a great religious awakening spread across the land based on this fear. Hellfire preachers preached from tents on the edges of towns. People were forced to reconsider the guilt of their lives, to repent. They recited biblical texts to the beat of piano and guitar music. This was the first introduction of popular instruments into the church service. People suddenly began to talk in tongues, begging for their salvation. They were born again. And finally, many looking for a spiritual refuge after their conversion joined the Shakers, swelling their ranks. Contrary to Calvinist belief in the individual's action in the world, Shakers believed only in the good of their internal group. While Puritans lived in fear or anticipation of the next life ahead, the Shakers believed that heaven could be possible now as a utopia on earth. There's a conflict between the individualism of Puritans and the yearning for a group free of sexual and economic competition.
We've got to talk to our membership. We've got to mobilize them. We gotta politicize them. We gotta say to Bill Davis and company, we need legislation on plant closing, and if you don't do it, step aside. We'll put somebody in the door.
Thank you. satellite zoom into the living room. Muzak does it, really, really does it. It's the Route 66 of the microchip boom. Muzak does it, really, really does it. Big Brother's watching, but what do we care? Yes, they do it, they really, really do it. With clever jamming, you won't know that they're there. Now they can't do it, they really can't do it. I got switch fever. I'm a tech diva. I'm atomic synth, the natural, strictly modern made. Electromotive force is the name of my trade. Hooked on hybrid, floating to the sun. Social indifference, out for fun. Prelude to space, before the dawn. Cosmic clouds, our history's punk. Cause I got switch fever. I'm a tech diva. I'm atomic synth, the natural, strictly modern made. Electromotive force is the name of my trade. Islands in space really aren't that far. They're perfect modern stations, complete with bar. Factory fresh dolls in every room. Welcome to the new dawn, a satellite room. Cause I got switch fever. Oh, I got switch fever. I'm a tech diva. I'm a tech diva. I'm atomic synth, the natural, strictly modern made. Electromotive force is the name of my trade. Scanning the spectrum for radio waves. Frequencies can make you lovesick, cause I got switch fever. I'm a tech diva. I'm a switching tech and diva. I'm a toxic, the natural, strictly modern made. Electromotive force is the name of my trade. Fever. Oh, I got switch fever. Oh, I got switch fever. Oh, I got tech fever. I'm a switching tech and diva. I'm a switching tech and diva. Cause I got switch fever. Oh, I got that fever.
Thank you. the
hot dog, that's where my money goes. My casa coca, she's a New Yorker.
I buy her anything to keep her in style, to keep her in style.
She's got a great big nose just like a garden hose.
Hot dog, that's where my money goes. Hot dog, that's where my money goes.
Me otherwise.
And colder.
I was, of course, left behind.
Winters grew longer. There were extreme
rumors abound. There are tales of real estate transactions,
torrential rains,
relocations, disappearances, tales of aborted projects, catastrophes, and then great black silence.
The sun's action.
Well, he could be anywhere, you know. Out of state, out of body, out of mind.
The gravity of the moon.
He might have gone to colonize planet 3 to think.
Changes in the distribution of the Earth's mass.
No one seems to know anything more than rumor.
There were volcanic eruptions.
Or then again, perhaps it happened like this.
Fishers.
He went out to get a pack of cigarettes, stopped for a beer, and met this man at the bar.
The Western coastline.
You know how that can be.
Looked eastward.
He forgot to go home.
The Imperial Valley.
But that was weeks ago, you say.
The city of a century sank.
And now the city has shifted.
Changes in the orbital geometry.
I sent a letter of inquiry.
Are caused by the gravitational
It was returned. Stamped whereabouts unknown. No forwarding address. That was before the city had shifted.
On the other side of the sun.
Rumors. The of what were called acts of expediency.
Trembled. The great vertical city split in two.
It is said that the chemical bank had fallen into the hands of other map makers.
Into a vast
construction and development.
Sea.
Monitoring systems for drainage
there
was their objective. Not alchemy.
Military controls, legions of the lost.
According to the
ruined
map, a man left the house one day,
a shifting,
and without apparent motivation, he simply vanished.
Massive accumulation.
The man who attempted to find him by retracing his steps
jolted the spin,
followed the same course.
The wobble increased,
he became what he pursued
until it exceeded the equilibrium point. The spin became unstable.
All the city shifted.
The earth tumbled over
some
in space.
Some to the right, some to the left.
The sun appeared
the cities
fixed
of desire,
in the sky.
And the cities of despair.
The city of buried angels vanished.
Please, no smoking.
On the subject of sleep and dreams, we should mention a singular belief that has obtained credence for many centuries, that to wake up in tears is a sign of impending evil. Two instances of this omen coming true have been brought before our notice in the same family. One was of a lady who woke up to find herself weeping bitterly, and under the impression, an impression, not a dream, that all her brothers and sisters were dead. Ere many months were over, a still nearer and more beloved relative was attacked with illness which proved fatal. And the other was of a gentleman who woke one morning with his pillow wet with tears, a circumstance especially unusual for a man, and shortly afterwards heard of the death, in consequence of an accident, of a valued relative in a distant land. We trust we shall not be considered skeptical when we relegate both to the region of curious coincidences. So, the old superstition of fire burning blue under ghostly influence is explained by the physical fact that when the mind is under the tension of anxiety or grief, the eye becomes so affected as only to be able to discern the blue rays of light. In the Louvre Gallery in Paris, there are two pictures by the same artist, and Innocence.
I went in to see Eileen. She's home from Boston.
The following story is related of them.
She came home yesterday.
A French painter, being desirous of painting a picture
and
of innocence, stopped at a cottage door and asked the mistress of the house to allow him to depict her beautiful little boy in that character.
She can stagger around a bit on
she
her own
consented,
with a walking stick.
And the picture was painted. Many years afterwards, he wished to paint a companion picture to be called Guilt.
He certainly won't be able to manage those stairs.
visiting one of the prisons in search of a face.
Nothing, they're packing up, they're ready to...
He saw a man...
Show up and trot off to Australia.
Perfectly answered the purpose. Permission was granted.
He was in, I believe, the last time I spoke to him, he was in
to his horror,
East Reach.
He found
after a while, they
conversation with the man.
Sent her from East Reach to Trinity Hospital, a place I'd never heard of before. But it used to be the old workhouse in Taunton. It's at the back of East Reach. In some beautiful gardens.
In an early portion of this branch.
Beautiful, certainly a beautiful layout, and a very modern car park layout there as well. Plenty of room for everybody.
One of the most curious is a story related
to... I seem to have done very little by gallop up and down between here and Taunton. For some reason or other, either down the hospital or... I shot down last week to go to a sale. Comet, the discount place.
In a style far superior to her own.
First now, let myself a new vacuum cleaner.
Worked at her picture.
Hoover, upright job.
Schoolfellows.
Certainly does its stuff because.
Traced her over the style
painting. 2 days filled a blooming bag in their disposal. It looks like it's going to cost me a fortune in blooming dust bag or something. Ever as well worth it before. The carpet certainly seemed to. I think if I remember rightly, I bought it up here with Mum. That was about 10 years ago, 10, 12 years ago. The motor's all right, but I mean, I don't seem to shift the door all that much. Certainly the new one does. Last Monday, I helped out. They're, this weekend I'm trotting off down to Plymouth. Won't be going down till Saturday afternoon after lunch.
In a ward of the hospital at the port.
Be busy in the morning.
A poor young man.
But I don't know what I told you before. Uncle Arthur's taking early retirement. It's come through.
And
confirmed that it's April. He'll be retiring in April. And incidentally, somebody else has taken early retirement too. Peter Jellis. I think he finishes next month or March. He'll be 64. But we'll pay him to finish up 12 months before. A bit early for me yet. I don't think I should be sorry to finish up.
Please, no smoking.
He sees it by her. In bed, and he said.
Take off your pants. Fuck you tonight. Boys roll dice for drink doubles and nothing. Imitate a rooster for dinner. Get some rage things. Not to again. It was the first time in a mercy just scenario. She feels like save the girl. She has to be.
Hey,
about he's.
Perhaps.
Feels a counterclockwise.
Expectation thought. And the action is different. Thought, she's different. Infection. Just took one look at her foot and made a yuck.
être près de quoi, elle se demande son intrigue. Forget about that sweet fuck, baby.
How she sees it by her, 3 o'clock a.m., June 6, 1981. Comme le voit par elle. Visi is van ihr aussieht. He was in bed and he said, take off your pants. Why do you think I'm here? Because I want to fuck you. I want to fuck you tonight. She goes to the loo. He was in bed and he said, but not in so many words. I think that I'm nervous that your husband is leaving town. It throws off the balance. The balance of what, she wonders, his intrigue. Forget about that sweet fuck, baby. Oublie ce dispèse, mon petit. Vergessen Susan Fick, baby. You disappointed me. I think you're a bitch. I'm not fishing with you this week. I'm not going to take care of you either. Just in case you had any ideas about that, you must be getting money from him or your parents. You wanted to see Paranoid? Or is she not aware of something? She's now listening to Fight Upstairs, screams between. He's snoring now. He kissed her and cut her throat simultaneously. She's at a funny place in her mind at this moment. Bewildered and angry, she thinks about how
she sees it by her.
How she's taken care of herself at different times in her life. She's vulnerable yet strong. Her vulnerability is her strength. She likes to try different things. She was smart to save money while she was making money, and her savings were just gone. The Zimbo show and the paperwork out on Monday, then she'll be very happy and short for some moments. Hooker outside says, going out. She's pretty bummed out tonight because last night was so great. She hoped tonight would be warm and fun. It was warm and fun, but also cold and political. He said that some nights this week when he stayed with her, he really didn't want to be there. Killer patterns.
Eventually, I close up this window. And lock the door so people can't come up to the window. Or else my day off. No, actually, it's not my day off, but I won't be working here. But it's pretty close to closing time now. Move around? I drive around. Lately, I've gotten really comfortable. I have a good time driving around. As long as I stay off the main streets, I'm happy.
There was something.
Stick to the alleyways. Stay away from downtown. No.
It was very clear. Very clear.
Oh, geez, you name it. Everybody rents it. Politicians, plumbers, restaurateurs, artists.
No doubts at all. Feeling is feeling.
Yeah, actually, there's something exciting about through a couple of our clients, our more recent clients. That'd be a good idea. Give you a better idea of what it's like here.
That's exciting. That's very exciting. That's something.
Kleiner Perkins? Sounds like a law firm. Automation Systems Incorporated in Walnut Creek, California.
An acceptance. A chance.
Solemn and Associates?
More than a chance.
S-O-L-E-N?
A law.
Photo and Sound Los Angeles, it's one of our other affiliates.
A smile.
Holiday Inn. Travelodge. Oh, here's a good one. The Department of Continuing Education. The University of California.
And I...
PT&T. They're a very big, important client of ours.
And I... For music.
AT&T.
And I...
Pizza Hut.
For music.
Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut. The Hut. The Hut. The Hut. The Hut. The Hut. The Hut. Pizza Hut. Hut. That's last week's, that's some of last week's clients. It's pretty much what it looks like. Well, and 9 minutes would be official closing time. Besides, there's no one here but you and I anyway, no one would know.
And it's very fun.
I'm not very excited by my job. It's too exciting, all the things that go on after I leave work. If that weren't so exciting, probably my job would be more tolerable.
It was very simple, really, very simple. Simple.
The Holiday Cottage. The rain beats against the window behind the bed, on which he is lying naked on his back. His arms are stretched out on either side, his wrists tied tightly with two nylon stockings to the iron bedposts at the top of the bed. His legs are open, stretched out, each ankle tied to the bedposts at the bottom of the bed. His mouth is gagged with a piece of cloth. She is standing on the far side of the bedroom, smiling. She stubs out her cigarette in the ashtray on the bedside table, removes her shoes, stockings and pants, and climbs onto the bed. She kneels astride, facing him. She unfastens her belt and unbuttons her dress, then slowly pulls it over her head. She unhooks her bra and drops it onto the floor beside the bed. She unbraids her long hair and trails it across his body and face. Sweat breaks out on his forehead as he writhes helplessly. His eyes shut tight. His teeth bite into the gag. His fingernails dig into his palms. Spasms run through him from head to foot. He thrashes from side to side, then slowly subsides. She straightens up and smiles. His breathing returns to normal. His eyes begin to close. When he awakes, she is no longer in the room. The rain has stopped. A breeze stirs the curtains. The sun shines through the window onto his face. The sweat has dried on his body. He shivers. His movements have tightened the knots in the stockings which secure his hands and feet. He flexes his fingers and toes and shifts position as best he can to ease the numbness in his limbs. He listens carefully. There is no sound. Outside the window, the sky is blue. A seagull sits on the window ledge watching him. The sun begins to set. The sky through the window is red. The wind has dropped. He can hear the sound of the waves breaking against the foot of the cliffs below the cottage, and the raucous calls of the rooks coming home to roost. In the distance, the cries of the curlews in the estuary. The light begins to fade. A moth settles on his face. A spider spins a web between the bedpost and the wall. It becomes dark.
Score, New York 3, Detroit 1.
Ramta, the XM-1 tank, America's newest battle ram. Chrysler designed, Chrysler built, toughest in the world. Ramta Dodge pickup, engineered and built by Chrysler like no other truck in the world. More galvanized steel in critical areas. More than Ford or Chevy. XM-1 tank, Dodge trucks. Built by the new Chrysler Corporation for America's toughest jobs.
Dodge trucks are Ramta.
Super merchandise, super bargains inside, super bargains inside, super bargains outside, super bargains inside, super bargains in, and your way into the back to the left, to the right, to the right, to the right, this side of this count, Calvin Klein, Sergio Valenti, Aaron Klein, Louis Jordan, Diego Dan, Bonjour, Cecil, Sergio Valenti, ladies, Sergio Valenti fans, on sale right now for $27, $60 pence, Sergio Valenti. Going for $27, hurry up ladies, hurry up, they'll just nail your chance, and number one sales store at 77 Chamber Street, nail your chance, merchandise from New York, from Chicago, from Los Angeles, San Francisco, Denver, Dallas, nail your chance from New York, Paris and Rome, domestic and imported merchandise, nail your chance, all the way in the back ladies, all the way in the back, to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right, to the sign of this count. Watch your step, ladies. Watch your step, sir. Just don't get excited. Now's your chance. Caffè italiano. Avanti, avanti. La bella signorina, la bella signora, avanti. Milano, Torino, Roma, Palermo, Salerno, Napoli, Firenze, Venezia, Venezia, Genova. Siena, Sardegna, Siciliana, la bella signorina, la bella signora, facci terra, per favore, facci terra.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a good day.
Off the rack, off the rack. Now hear this, ladies, now hear this. Now just pretty girls, pretty ladies, watch your step coming in, watch your step. Merchandise outside, inside, and all the way back to the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. Designer discounts, Jordache, Calvin Klein, Louis Jordan, Gloria Vanderbilt, and Klein, Cecil, Bonjour, Sergio Valenti. Girls, that's right, ladies, Sergio Valenti. Sergio Valenti pants going on sale right now for $27. $60 pants going on sale right now for $27. Charlotte Klein sunglasses, 100% sunglasses going on sale right now for $14. Can you beat that? That just, can you beat that? Now's your chance.
Well, just tell me straight, as much as you can remember about the dream in 30 seconds or less.
30 seconds?
Or whatever.
Okay, and what was the criteria for dreaming?
Well, this was the end of the world type dream with the nuclear bomb there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Maybe, but that was the category as the end of the world.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell me when to start.
We're rolling here.
Oh, okay. Well, my dream was really more about the statue. then about the end of the world, but I dreamed that there was going to be, there was a war, and the planes had, it's an old-fashioned dream because there aren't any missiles in it, and the plane had gone overhead and had dropped the atomic bomb, and everybody was running around, and the bomb fell and personally hit me in the forehead and knocked me out, and what the dream was really about, and it didn't go off. And so I was a hero because it pointed out the futility of war. And so then the problem was then how to design this sort of statue to put up that was like me prone on this marble slab with an atomic bomb sticking out of my forehead. That's it.
Wow, seeing is believing. We're going to give you turtleneck shirt for $3. Dress shirts, $9, 3 to $25. We're going to give you Tully Silvana's sport jacket for only $19. Cassini jackets, $9. White leisure suits, $9.90. Putney sweaters, $5. McGregor slacks, only $8.90. Come one and come all. You're going to see it. You're not going to believe it. It's a sale of a lifetime now going on at American Liquidators. We buy the inventory of famous men's clothing firms that are going out of...
Test, test. One, two. Test. Testing. One, two.
Take on an arm of the telecom.
Testing 1 2 3 4 5 5 4 3 2 one dose of airport radio on 1 2 2 1. Testing 1 2 3 4 5 5 4 3 2 1
dose of airport radio on 1 2 1 gate 5. Dose reporting 21 0. Three zeros scattered, 50 scattered, visibility 10, MSL 144, minus 17, minus 19, 03 at 25, gusting 32, 994, stratocumulus 4, stratocumulus 1, drifting snow, 8005, Hotel 5855 71910 41565 40325 11165 211 884 10144 58005 73601 84500. But
thank you.
But I know what.
Yesterday, we had dogs. Known as husky dogs in English. And when they want their dogs to be good and strong, they train them about the weight, what they have to pull, not too heavy, not too light. And when this man wants this dog to be his true companion,
How this dog was trained was to pull the sled with harnesses and ropes made from square flipper, hide,
All the dogs in our cave doors that were shot down by RCMP the reason the RCMP gave us was because they bred so many puppies.
Two voices. Inside a dark space, remembering, recreating an image,
searching
for a meaning. Only the sounds of these words are filling the space. The words have been written down, deliberately selected. The script is complete. Nothing can be changed. The voice seems calm. The speaker is nervous. Closed in her hand is a small white feather. You spoke?
No.
I thought you spoke. What are you doing? Trying to watch. But you're not looking at me. Should I be? The script says you should be looking into the camera. Can't we change it? Tomorrow, perhaps. But it can be seen differently. Not if you remember what we agreed. The model, posing motionless. The artist, watching. But yesterday, I was watching. Yesterday, there was the sound of the bird calling. It's all in the script. A white bird in an empty space. I remember. Something touched my face. The sunlight blinded me. Two voices. The subject, the spectator, the model, the artist. Motionless, inside a dark space, remembering. The sky was darkening, the shore was in heavy shadow. Deserted, except for a white object. A woman seated in a pool of light, posed as if no one is watching. The woman, moving her head slowly towards the camera, her eyes averted from the spectator. Slowly a white bird flies overhead, at first just beyond her line of vision. It circles, gliding down to land on the shore, reminding me of a memory. I want to add a line. What? I still like the white feather. It's a sunny evening. Warm breeze. A white object in an empty space. Nothing else will happen. I don't know. I'm waiting for it to happen. The edge is very close. An unbearable tension. A broken bird split open in a dark corner, bursting with song. Shattered by a single shot. White feathers in an empty sky. A casual shot. Singing in the tree, knocked down to the concrete. The sunlight through the leaves, glinting on metal, shining on my face, obliterating the view. Tomorrow we will sing again. Screaming through the clear air. It flew away. It touched my face as it fell. I took no action. Just warm feathers. In the palm of my hand. Two voices. The artist. The model. In the same dark space. Remembering a recurring image.
Station for the whole of the Among those I know, Victor rang. 6 p.m. Senses. And lots of... Today I had but the lightest of luncheons. A grilled pearl. One squeezed limone, senza strofinaccio, yipes, that's a corker. An 8-minute intimation with my pal Al, as you know, I rarely talk, who is married to a chair. No more than 13 strawberries, deuce, and a heck of a lot of used air. Today she weighs the result of edible observation, a revenge at last of pardonable spirits, answered by vindicated example, exemplified by horrid adequacy, and 25 pines of plum stones. The gentle rain swooped playfully on my own dear shack. Reclining on me kitchen chaise, black with white paping, I peruse the arbor opposite. O gentle tree, what secrets do those boughs contain? What life has passed your knotty bole, I seemed to think. I try to think. I think. I sometimes try. Sometimes I think I sit and wait. Sometimes I simply sit. I sit and think of what I wish. And if I taste or waste. Dut, dut, dut.
Well, here we are in the world of it.
Get the picture? Lance stood somewhere. considering his choice of chance. Took a rain check, and I look on, in wellies. Lance was a lonely coat, and prone to move. His days had been numbered, though not always accountable. No, not by a long way. He knew the size of milk, but always bought in cartons. Two parents, five gerbils, one canary, and the odd scarf for the colder night. Lance grew older. He liked tom-toms, tragedy, tinned comforts, timed consequences, and two-toned, two-piece tailor-mades. Lance. A bit of a squeaky beaker when it came to taking El Chancellito. But I forget that there's few that know the incessant quirks of my little Tracy, ensconced in a brandy glass on my gilt boudoir mantle. What a piece! What a fish! And Lance. What of Lance with his library subscription and geraniums, lilting subsidence and gravy dip, lamplit soliloquies and graveyard idiosyncrasies? Get the picture? Lance. Lost in mustard and macrame. Lance. Looking for hope and Hawaiian wallpaper. Lance. Dancing on his nose for the time being. I don't do that to you, so why do you do that to me? As you know, I rarely... Love's a brittle sort of thing. That's what I wear, that's why I wear what I do. Because I'm that sort of a person. Experience has left me repeated, probably sitting on an aeroplane, making lists. You are brave, little man. I like you. Teeth and other emotions. But what about my thorax and the distilled essence of my own thoughts? Photos and other females. Her teeth parted, and, from a considerable amount of height, I saw her try to forget it. They often leave me sighs and other gifts. Vague and twitching with a cold desire, she smiled. No, I may call you Hillary, mayn't I? The tufted ducks look more marvellous than ever. Darling, you might even be on holiday looking like that. Oh, lovely, lovely goldfish soup. Heck, darling, it just slipped out. But I am just at this moment leaving for a bus to Hounslow. To avoid the torment of social life. Iron madness. Discipline? Ketchup. A man with an obsession to kill, thinking of buying a camera, her distinctive style and warm personality caught the attention of unusual computers. There's something about the world we live in. Pulverized a jam jar, damn it. Full of Friday on average. But how long will the people continue to discuss the weather with complete strangers, apparently placed at the foot of a very long table? Should I wait until someone speaks to me? Perhaps they've never known real love.
taken from here to where it came from, and taken to a place, and used in such a manner that it can only remain as a representation of what it was, where it came from.
supposing that the centripetal force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance of the places from the center, bum, it is required to define the spaces which a body falling directly describes in given times. Bum. Case 1. If the body does not fall perpendicularly, it will describe some conic section whose focus is placed in the center of force. Bum. Suppose that conic section to be ARBP and its focus S. Bum. And first, if the figure be an ellipse, bum, upon the greater axis thereof AB describe the semicircle ADB. Bum. And let the right line DPC pass through the falling body. Bum. Making right angles with the axis. Bum. And drawing DS. Bum. PS, the area ASD. Bum. Will be proportional to the area ASP. Bum. And therefore also to the time. Bum. The axis AB. Bum. Still remaining the same. Bum. Let the breadth of the ellipse. Bum. Be continually diminished. Bum. And the area ASD. Bum. Will always remain proportional to the time. Bum. Suppose that breadth. Bum. To be diminished ad infinitum. Bum. And the orbit ARP. Bum. In that case. Bum. Coinciding with the axis AB. Bum. And the focus S. Bum. With extreme point of the axis B. Bum. The body will descend to the right line AC. Bum. And the area ABD. Bum. Will become proportional to the time. Bum. Therefore, the space AC. Bum. Will be given which the body describes. Bum. In a given time. Bum. By its perpendicular fall. Bum. From the place A. Bum. If the area ADP. Bum. Is taken proportional to the time. Bum. From the point D. Bum. The right line DC. Bum. Is let fall perpendicularly. Bum. On the right line. Bum. AB. Bum. 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 Bum.
Case 2. If the figure RPB is an hyperbola on the same principal diameter AB describe the rectangular hyperbola BED, and because there exist between the several areas and the heights CP and CD relations, CSP is to CSD as CBF is to P. And since the area SPFB varies as the time in which the body P will move through the arc PFB, the area SDEB will also vary as that time. Let the latest rectum of the hyperbolum RPB be diminished in infinitum, the transverse axis remaining the same.
Bum, bum, bum.
And the arc PB will come to coincide with the right line CB, and the focus S with the vertex B, and the right line SD with the right line BD. And therefore, the area BDEB will vary as the time in which the body C, by its perpendicular descent, describes the line CBQEI. Case 3. And by the like argument, if the figure RPB is a parabola, and to the same principal vertex B, another parabola, BED, is described, that may always remain given, while the former parabola, in whose perimeter the body P moves, by having its latest rectum diminished and reduced to nothing, comes to coincide. The parabolic segment BDEB will vary as the time in which the body P or C will descend to the center S or B, QEI. The things above found being supposed, I say, that the velocity of a falling body in any place C is to the velocity of a body describing a circle. At the distance BC, as the square root of the ratio of AC, the
distance of the body from the remoter vertex A of the circle or rectangular hyperbola to 1/2 AB, the principal semi-diameter of the figure. Let AB, the common diameter of both fingers, RPB, DEB. And draw a right line, PT, that may touch the figure, RPB, in P, and likewise cut that common diameter, AB, produced, if need be, in T. And let SY be perpendicular to this line, and BQ perpendicular to this diameter, and suppose the latest rectum of the figure RPB to be L. From corollary 9, proposition 16, it is manifest that the velocity of a body moving in the line RPB about the center S in any place P is to the velocity of a body describing a circle about the same center at the distance SP as the square root of the ratio of the rectangle 1/2 LSP to SY squared. For by the properties of the conic sections, AC, CB, is to CP squared as 2AO to L, and therefore 2CP squared AO over ACP is equal to L. Therefore, those velocities are to each other as the square root of the ratio CP squared AOSP over ACB. Moreover, by the properties of the conic sections, CO is to BO as BO is to TO. Thence, CO plus BO is to BO as BO plus TO is to TO. And CO is to BO as CB is to BT. From this, BO minus CO is to BO as BT.
Thank you. Fingers music. Solo left. Solo right. Double. Chorus.
Don't touch that dial, because it's time now for the HP Dinner Show, the radio program scientifically designed to help you prepare, eat, and digest your dinner. And now, here they are, live at the mics, HP.
Good evening, my friends, and thank you for welcoming us into your homes today. A lot of us have come to think of our radios as little icons perched up there on top of our refrigerators or under our stereos in the living room. And with good reason, because the radio is a little icon. A little physical embodiment of all that is good regarding science and technology. Yes, that's right. Now, I know when I say that radio is a symbol of all that is good, a lot of you out there will scoff. A lot of you think that we were better off in the olden days. You say that if it hadn't been for science and technology, we would be living an easier life, that all these aids to modern living have enslaved us to the 40-hour work week, to taxes, to enormous wars, and even to potential nuclear annihilation. The cavemen only worked a little bit. They worked maybe 8 hours a week, not 8 hours a day. And in more technical places like Japan, the people are working even harder than us. Well, I know this. I've heard this before. We've all heard it before. And that if progress continues in its tidal wave progression, we're going to be working even harder than we are now. And if we haven't blown ourselves from here to kingdom come, that is kaboom. That's one way of looking at it. That's one point of view. And there are some other points of view, like you listeners out there who think how grand all this is, all this science and technology, while you play with your video games, while you play with your home computers, your robot chess games, and drive around in your cars, wearing out the roads, driving over the pedestrians, poison in the air for the cyclists on your comfortably padded seats. You rejoice in the technical expertise practiced by our distilleries. You think nothing of paying 50% taxes to the government on every bottle of rum, of vodka, brandy, gin, aquavit, rye, schlibovitz, ouzo, bourbon, Irish, and scotch. And if it doesn't mildly upset you, you forget about it soon enough. Praise be the spirit of the fruit. And if it does mildly upset you, you forget about it soon enough with the help of the toasters, the help of the TV, and the Pop-Tarts powered by thermonuclear-enriched uranium electrical generating plants. It's cheap. We live longer. There are ways around the taxes. And the liquor is awful good. Don't it taste good? Hallelujah. Thanks be to science and technology. Sure. I know this, and that's why I wanted to talk to each and every one of you today about the radio. Now, every one of you should search within your mind whether or not you believe in the mind theory. Open all the drawers up there within your old-fashioned skull bones that radio has written on them. Take out those files and have a deep, hard look. Because it's time now to listen to the radio. It's time now to listen to the radio that's been scientifically developed to help you to prepare, eat, and digest your dinner. It's time now for the HP Dinner Show.
Click, click, click. loved Dominic Lush.
Thank you. Everybody's saying, I love you. Growth and pleasure. Changed direction. I took action. Came alive.
Did you have some man's talk?
pleasure is the point of our existence.
Thank you for being our sort of people. One really did come out of the blue. Have a tan.
Why isn't all our life as beautiful and sensual?
It at last.
Forever.
Thank you.
act of resistance. Respond to pressure. Destroying the frontiers.
But a passport really separates me from birth to death. Because even when I am dead, I cannot be buried where a white man is buried. A pass in South Africa is not merely an identity. A pass in South Africa for an African controls the whole life. If you haven't got it, you fall into prison for the length of time until your relations know where you are. In which case, sometimes they don't even know you're in jail. I have very strong feelings against the passport. It means to me that I'm a slave, that I can't move, that I can't do anything. We have no voice of our own. It is the changing of the whole system.
A way of survival.
My freedom was disciplined and controlled, and no longer, because I was with a man or a boy or whatever, was I allowed to actually move in and out freely because of the suspicions of sexual activity. Oh, I never fell in love. Never. No, I get sort of crushing lusts. But I never fell in love until more recently. I did feel as though I had no control over the situation and was a bit distressed by my submission. Sexuality for my long-term relationship just never kind of comes to anything very much. I've only had one relationship where body was truly shared and enjoyed. Being dead honest with you, I'm saying actually what I feel, and I'm saying to you what I'd probably say to a woman. Yet, the response I get is quite different to a woman's response.
Not being confined. Searching for common ground.
And jail means once you are in there, you get sold. See, you're not, it's not even discussed with you. Farmers come to the prison and they come and buy. Well, once you have the passbook and you sign for it, it's absolute slavery. Nothing more than that. This is my own personal description of it. And I had to sneak there and go and live with him. As long as the law did not find out. Well, the only advantage is that they can keep track of you. They can regulate your movement.
Hiding the tracks. Running out of space. Not being confined.
Just being able to get up and do things and have no restrictions about it. I could be whatever I wanted to be. It makes me feel trapped because I feel incapable of being in control. But the nicest way to show your body is with someone that you really have a good mental understanding with. that you are physically attracted to. And I think the mental thing comes first. It's ultimate, it's wonderful. I mean, it is the nicest thing. You don't have to think about anything. I mean, the actual act of penetration.
Secret actions, secret spaces, secret actions, secret spaces.
You've got everything controlled. I can't get out of it, I can't move within it, I can't get a job. I don't feel there's a future for me in it, I don't feel there's a future for you. What are you going to do when I end up at the bottom of this block of flats? What do you do with all the people that just can't take it anymore? And all the slashed wrists and people in the mental loony bin? Do you ever feel responsible for them? Because you're where it started. It started with you all those years ago, all those weeks ago, all those hours ago. You've just condemned so many people. You know, it doesn't matter about your conscience anyway, does it? You know, you just rub it off. You're just another part of it. You never accept that universal guilt, would you? We're just replacing each other with lumps of paper. We're just noting down everything we know about each other, human being. What good's that, you know? What does that do? You give the information, well, you know where it goes in the end? It just comes down into the pockets of those who'll destroy us. And that number will get smaller and smaller, and our number will get bigger and bigger. And that number will
be what? Food? You want to know that about food? Okay, should we do sex first and then food? Where do I keep my food? Oh, is it separate? Does it touch? The two bits of cheese, do they touch in the fridge? Or are they on different plates? Well, you sent a man round, and he didn't even ask to see my cheese. I mean, we're talking about the untouchables here. That's it. Live with someone as an untouchable. Then it would be really fastidious, it would really suit, wouldn't it? It's wrong. You shouldn't have to ask me these things, you know. Am I a dependent? I have never been dependent. Maybe when I was breastfed. I haven't been dependent for years. That's an insult suggesting that I'm a dependent of someone. Do you mean as soon as I have sex with a man, instantly I become dependent? Instantly, I lose all free will. I cannot even make myself a cup of tea. Is that what you mean? Let alone earn myself a living. Now, I'm great.
Are people on Social Security scroungers? Right? Do they just want to scrounge a living off Social Security in order not to be able to do anything? It's put about that people, you know, like, again, you know, scrounging, willing to scrounge off the state. I mean, for one thing, is it scrounging? I mean, for one thing, where's the money come from in the first place? You know, do these rich, you know, the ruling class, sort of out of their own pocket, that they have earned themselves through their own sweat, pay out to keep the rest of the population alive? I mean, it's only through what the population, the working class, has provided the ruling, the wealth, to enable it to pay itself back. Exactly what is creating this crisis? Exactly what is creating unemployment? It isn't immigrants. What is creating it? It's not just unemployment in this country. You've got unemployment throughout Europe, in America. Capitalism's in its death row.
Ship me. You don't know what a nuisance is. You don't know me. You wait. Ship me if you think you can. I hear you. You try ship me. Listen to him. He's like one of the nuisance. He doesn't know what a nuisance is, does he? I mean, look, I've been waiting around this place. I mean, there's nobody. You come and you namby-pamby, you send me to this place, you send me to that place. I mean, God, this waiting is killing me. In this country, you wait and everything. You people can't wait for it. In Jamaica, people don't wait, you know. Maybe it's a bit of a problem, that, I suppose. But they won't wait. They don't wait at all. It's trouble. Trouble if you keep people shifting around. You make an appointment, you should come and see the person, have the appointment. You shift from one person to another person. You come here, that person's gone to lunch. I mean, Ship me. If you think I cause a nuisance, you better see me now, or else, you know. I'd sit down here on the floor, I'd tell you about it. I mean, what are you, racist or something? Is it because I'm black, you don't want to look upon me? I mean, what happened? Am I dirty in the foyer of your establishment? I mean, if you want me, move, you better stay me or
tell me that there's something going on, because otherwise, why do I get this sort of treatment, you see? And I can only think that if you've got this huge file, and I think about what you might have on that file, that some of it is... I think that on paper I could look like a real failure, and look like, to you, I must look like I am... I don't know what kind of people that you'd put under firing squad or something, you'd people that society doesn't want, you know, sort of people you'd put in the dustbin. Not surprising, I suppose you would treat me pretty badly. I get the same really horrible feeling, you know, it's not a pleasure in any way, you feel just a piece of... flesh to be prodded about with and poked about with. And I often cry. I just end up crying, I think.
I'm a man of means, by no means king of the road. Third boxcar, midnight train, destination, Bangor, Maine. Feel I'm going back to Massachusetts. Pennies in a stream, falling leaves of sycamore, moonlight in Vermont. Start spreading the news, I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. Now I live and breathe in Philadelphia freedom. By the time we got to Woodstock, we were 500,000 strong. And everywhere there was song and celebration. Pulled into Nazareth, was feeding about 5:30 dead. In the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia, country road, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, country road, take me home. She's my Tallahassee lassie from down in FLA. Holly came from Miami, FLA. Hitchhiked her way across the USA. A hustle here and a hustle there. Bonnie and Clyde began their evil doing one sunny afternoon round Savannah way. Virgil Kane is my name, and I rode on the Danville train. I'm leaving on that midnight train to Georgia. Pardon me, boys, is that the Chattanooga choo-choo? Take the last train to Clarksville. I can meet you at the station. You can be there by 4:30, 'cause I've made your reservation. Don't be slow. Help me, information. Get me Memphis, Tennessee. I was dancing with my darling to the Tennessee waltz. Nashville cats play clean as country water. Mississippi, you've been on my mind. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one who's gonna let me blue. In a bar in Toledo, across from the depot, on a barstool she took off her ring. Indiana wants me, Lord, I can't go back there. Take a look around at Selma, Alabama. Tin soldiers, index in common, we're finally on our own. This summer I hear the drummin' for dead in Ohio. Last night I went to sleep in Detroit City, and I dreamed about those cotton fields and home. When I was a little bitty baby, my mama done and rocked me in the cradle in them old cotton fields back home. It was down in Louisiana, just about a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. Come on, take me to the Mardi Gras in the city of my dreams. You can legalize your loads, you can wear your summer clothes in New Orleans. Chicago is my kind of town. Chicago is my kind of razzmatazz. You know what made Milwaukee famous has made a loser out of me. I'm going to Jackson, look out Jackson Town. You've been talking about your Madison shoes. We got a thing we call the Madison Blues. Do the Madison Blues. Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train. Well, it goes to St. Louis, down to Missouri, Oklahoma City, looks so, so pretty, you'll see. Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kingman, Barstow, San Bernardino. Excuse me, do you know the way to Kansas City? And the Wichita lineman is still on the line. Only 24 hours from Tulsa, I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. Is this the way to Amarillo? Every night I've been hugging my pillow, dreaming dreams of Amarillo and sweet Marie who waits for me. Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Rattlesnake Speedway in the Utah desert, pick up my money and head back into town. Jojo left his home in Tucson, Arizona, standing on a corner in Winslow, Arizona. It's such a fine sight to see. There's a girl, my lord, in a flatbed Ford. She's slowing down to take a look at me. By the time I get to Phoenix, she'll be rising. Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas! Oh, I'm longing for San Bernardino. Home in Pasadena, there I'll settle down beneath those palms in someone's arms in Pasadena town. Oh, those Hollywood nights and those Hollywood hills, if you come to San Francisco, summertime will be a lovin' there. I'd be safe and warm if I was in L.A., California dreamin' on such a winter's day.
Let's be. It is simple. Things are not what they seem to be. On the face of it, past experience doesn't seem to provide an adequate basis for analysis or for assessment and judgment. In fact, there may be no distinctions to be made between one thing and something else, one action and another, one day and the next. They may have all become indistinguishable from each other. That is possible. But habits persist. For example, I think that I am the same as I was yesterday. I think I look the same. You look older to me. I notice the changes in your face and the fluctuations of your stamina. You look tired. It is you I'm looking at. It is yourself. I am the same as I've always been. But you are different. Dumb even. Like an animal. Someone made up my mind for me somewhere. Someone played with me. And I'm suffering from exposure to dangerous habits, from unwanted and unsolicited influences. But in my mind, everything remains as it has always been, since I can remember, when I was separated from myself at the early age. And that is the least of it. It's all the same when memory serves no purpose. Contradictory messages get scrambled somewhere between the mind and the body, and that is where I am. In confusion, where dreams and dreaming are deformed, disrupting the regions where dreams and day-to-day living are in cohabitation. That is where you are to me, where there is the fear of every sort of future. And in bitter contradiction, we fall over backwards unseen, to be caught in receptacles placed by the mothers and the fathers for the purpose. They say, there will be no disasters. Disasters will be leached out. There will be no catastrophes. They said so. They are clear about that. Yes, they are. They have told us so. They have said as much. They say, look, listen. There will be no disasters. There will be no catastrophes. Everything is as is, just so and so. And we know, we have been informed that provisions have been made for every foreseeable circumstance, that all eventualities will be accounted for. We have been informed. They will brook no questions. They will give no answers. There will be no discussions. There are no arguments. Everything is as provided. We have been informed. Dissension will not take place. There will be no dissension. There will be no disasters. There are no arguments. We are being accounted for. They say everything is as is, being just so, for the best possible reasons, in the best of possible worlds. Isn't that so?
loser!
You're losing!
You're a loser!
You lost
You're really lost!
You're losing!
Loser!
Loser,
loser, loser!
Loser!
You're a loser!
Loser!
You're a loser!
You lost again!
You lost again!
You're gonna lose!
You're a loser!
You're
a loser, loser, loser!
Loser!
You're a loser!
Loser!
You're a loser!
You're gonna lose!
Lose, 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 lose!
You're gonna lose!
You're a loser!
You're gonna lose!
You're gonna lose!
Lou, 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 L
Just listen to me. Everything going to be all right.
Listen to me. Everything is going to be all right.
Just listen to me. Everything going to be all right.
Listen. Everything is going to be all right.
Everything going to be all light. Just listen to me. Everything going to be all right.
Listen to me. Everything is going to be all right. Listen to me. Everything is going to be all right.
Just listen to me. Everything going to be all right.
Listen to me. Everything is going to be all light.
Just listen to me. Everything going to be all right. Just listen to me. Everything going to be all light.
Listen to me. Everything is going to be all right.
Someone had measured out their time. Someone had marked this day. Someone to whom no heed is paid. Neither hurry or delay. Those charming cockney lads. were to them man born. Revenge and death and violence was the code which they had sworn. Card games played in a back room, preparing for the fray, would play the ace of spades and challenge the name. Sank deep into his throat. The carpet turned red.
Did not bring them any tears.
When Jack the Hat
fell dead. Broken mirrors bleed silver light. They take no liberty. Buried in the underpass remains Jack's destiny.
The evidence there was evidence to support it, that he was a man given to extreme violence, but the slightest provocation that he did. Generated this feeling of terror, this susceptibility to violence to all kinds of people. They had almost total disregard for law and order and authority generally. This, to my mind,
born with nothing, it's not hard. A villain's life to choose. No rich man's laws will stop the poor. But what are they to lose?
We stare into the screen, learn nothing from the real. Keep our distance from the outside world, blind to what it will reveal.
And now in book and film and song,
their tale is told today. Hackneyed villain, hero lords, whose dreams are locked away.
The manifestation of counterconsciousness. An object-based consciousness predominates in our culture, that of society's institutions, and a person-based consciousness, that of the community, has to exist as a counterconsciousness, because the latter is considered subversive to a controlled, predetermined social fabric. The full social and psychological complexity of people is recognized in counterconsciousness, which is built around a mutual involvement between people. Implicit in this is the downgrading of the social priority of property. Counterconsciousness is self-organizing. Relationships between people are self-determined and formed between what they can mutually establish are their priorities and needs. Thus, in practice, all persons are more directly involved in establishing their own community, the one in which they live, and participating in the decisions that affect their daily life. Important to people that are actually living within the new reality is a fundamental fight back against the surrounding determinism. People simply don't want to give in easily, and, despite the enormous psychological and physical pressures on them towards their own passivity, there is a continual struggle to establish their own individual identity and to retain contact with other people living there where they live. Counterconsciousness here exists as a kind of underground network within the new reality and is a parallel world that is in an enforced coexistence with its surroundings. The totality of the isolating pressures within the new reality and the interlinking between media and physical reality make the construction of a coherent view extremely difficult. Generally, people's perceptual models of the surroundings in which they live are highly fragmented and contextual, built on just their own immediate experience. Such fragmented impressions, reactions and tensions contribute significantly to people's inability to act for themselves. However, if there is a chance for people to extend the boundaries of their contained lives by creating new territories of activity, then they can become an active context for the creation of a parallel world. The alienation of the territory must be important to the manifestation of such activities. They are in themselves alienates from the dominant culture that people are trying to escape from. Alienation is a crucial key to the building of an identity for those persons that go to the created territory, and their common, mutually shared hatred of the new reality is a catalyst for the formation of a larger community feeling that can be transferred back into everyday life within the confines of the housing estate. At another more subtle level, the destruction of the environment is not destruction at all, but is creative. People are simply registering their mark, showing that they exist. Acts of so-called vandalism as counterconsciousness are no more than anarchistic exhibition of people's energies and individualism. Also, acts of destruction are symbolic agents to the establishing of a counterconsciousness. For the group activities from which they arise, such as a hang around on stairways or the destroying of playground facilities, are really carried out by a lone person, but the result of a small group or gang. Context for counterconsciousness. The unofficial nature of the context established to express counterconsciousness is essential to their power as agent, but also equally important is their close relationship to the normal, daily behaviours of residents. While wastelands adjacent or within the new reality are a powerful context just to identify with, is how they are used to agency specific activities as diverse as track bike riding or glue sniffing that is really significant. Camp building is one example of how the wasteland is used to agency counterconsciousness. Sometimes small camps are constructed, comprising just a few car seats, but they can be quite elaborate, involving covered dugouts or structures that may even have a roof made of something like corrugated iron sheeting. The camp has many functions. Two important ones are that it acts as a focus for group activities, and at the same time provides a screen from the prying eyes of the surrounding urban world. Within the camp, the group or gang is safe to indulge in its own activities, create its own special languages and behaviours. Thus, the more inaccessible and hidden they are from the gaze of outsiders, so much the better. Pathways and open spaces become the context for track bike riding or horse riding, and while these are individualistic pursuits and often competitive, they still essentially rely on a group, be it an ad hoc one, for support. Other locations are used to furtively hide those parts of the new reality that are the most screened. Stairways, lift landings, the complex of sheds that are provided for resident storage, also garages, especially those that have been abandoned, the ones which always seem to have everyone's rubbish thrown into them. Interestingly, garages should be the one piece of private space that would have the potential to be a vehicle for residents to be creative and communicative. However, they are, of course, sited away from the actual blocks where they are living, and are nearly always without any services such as electricity or water, the basic ingredients for anything to be really created. On the other hand, where resistance has been more formally organised by residents through a tenants' association, then their own flats are often used, and this perhaps represents, symbolically, the most powerful context of all for manifesting counterconsciousness. the transportation of objects. Objects are important agents in the expression of counterconsciousness. However, in nearly all instances, their role is changed from the one given or assigned to them from the dominant authoritative culture from which they originate. The dominant culture's ownership of the means of production requires that an object's use is either transformed from the one intended or extended into a territory outside its boundaries in which counterconsciousness can be manifest. Here the object becomes an agent, as it is the means through which relationships are initiated and enabled within the group, or fantasy roles constructed by the individual. For example, the walker in the wasteland with his air rifle and dog sees himself as really the lone hunter in the forest or some backwoodsman's figure. Instead of an object symbolically replacing relationships with other people, as in a dominant cultural context, it is the means through which its pressures can be resisted. Objects are more tool-like. They are the trigger for exchanges between people, and their references, by this implication, extend into the community. If they do not already have this characteristic as inherent, then they are given it through transformation. One particularly interesting transformation is a can of glue, usually Evo stick. In one context, a can of Evo stick has a deterministic constructional role, i.e. the making and repairing of objects. This is its positivistic role within the dominant culture, but this is completely negated by young people transforming this by sniffing the glue in order to get high. Even more significant is the taking of the can of glue into a wasteland, where it is the prime agent for the building of a camp, an important agent for the generating of group cohesiveness. The crucial factor is that the very alienation of glue sniffing as an activity amongst young people from the dominant cultural norms is crucial to it functioning as their means of escape. Ultimately, the most important form of glue sniffing is communal, and involves a glue can being burnt on a fire, which forms the centre point of the camp, as this then involves the transformation of other objects as part of the resulting anarchistic group hire. Cars are driven into the wasteland and set fire to, then just left as rusting monuments to the group's activities, eventually to be taken over by the forces of the wilderness, and to find a harmony with them. This is again a specific transportation of an object from one context to another. Also, small objects that are already lying around, or have been brought over to the camp by the group, are just picked up and utilised, often with extreme points of energy. The can of glue is a highly symbolic object in this context because of what results from its transformation, as this in turn also results in other objects being transformed to act as agents for counterconsciousness. There are many other alien activities that involve transformation. For example, one extreme activity on the Avondale Estate, Hayes, West London, meant tenants standing on the bath in their flat so as to put their ear against the air vent outlet, and from this everyone's conversation the whole block could be heard, i.e. transformation of air vent to receiver.